Well, we're back in Sarajevo. Just behind me, you can see downtown. And they tell us that on this final weekend, the crowds have grown tremendously, that there are more than 100,000 people in town today to see the various events. On tonight's program, remember, women's figure skating. We're going to see ski jumping from the 90-meter hill. And right now, we're going to begin with the four-man bobsleds, real action on Mount Trebevich. Let's go up there now. Our commentator on the scene, Tim Brett.
This is Mount Trebevich, the big round-shouldered hill which towers nearly 4,000 feet above Sarajevo. Its lovely trails and scenic overlooks make it one of this country's most popular summer picnic areas. But today, it is the site of the finals in the four-man bobsled competition. This is Wolfgang Hoppe of East Germany. One week ago today, he drove his two-man sled to the gold medal. And after yesterday's first two runs, he has once again placed his name at the top of the leaderboard. If he goes on to win the four-man race, he'll join a list of immortals in the sport of bobsledding, because only three men have won double gold medals in the Olympic Games. In the 1952 Games in Oslo, Norway, a German baker named Andro Osler assembled a team of heavyweights that won both the two- and the four-man competition. 16 years later in Grenoble, Italian pilot Eugenio Monti revolutionized the sport when he introduced push bars, and that innovation helped produce the double gold for him. Then in 1976 in Innsbruck, East German Meinhard Nehmer raced to two gold medals in his country's first ever Olympic bob appearance. Nehmer then came back in 1980 to win the four-man competition in Lake Placid. Today, 26-year-old Wolfgang Hoppe will try to join the list of immortals as the youngest man in history to win his second bobsled gold medal in the same Olympic year. But to do it, he will have to hold off his countryman Bernhard Lehmann, who is just 19 hundredths of a second behind, while Swiss team number one, with Silvio Giobellina driving, is 57 hundredths of a second off the pace. You are looking at the East German's number one sled. It belongs to Wolfgang Hoppe, and just moments before the competition here, they are keeping it under wraps, not giving away any secrets. Hi again, everybody. I'm Tim Brandt, and there is no question about the fact that Wolfgang Hoppe has been the king of this hill for the past week. But there are some other teams with a legitimate shot at the top prize, and they are not conceding anything to the East Germans. Besides the ones that we've already shown you, there is Eckhard Fosser of Switzerland and Janis Kippers of the Latvian Republic. He represents the Soviet Union. He, too, is in striking condition. And Jeff Jost of the United States is in ninth place. So with two heats yet to go, there is still some spectacular racing yet to come. With me again today, John Morgan. And John, what has to happen for the East Germans to falter?
Well, the East Germans have to have a bad heat, and the Swiss have to have two super heats for the Swiss to catch them. It's possible, but the Swiss had one bad heat yesterday that really hurt them in the second heat, and they can't have that today. They have to have the two super heats, and the Swiss are famous in four-man competition, and you never know. Maybe they can do it.
It is a cloudy, cold day here at Mount Trebevich, 18 degrees, very little wind, and a light snow is now falling. The track is a little chewed up after yesterday's two heats, and with 24 teams, heavy sleds, and two more heats today, it could become treacherous. This is USA's number one driver, Jeff Jost, 36-year-old state policeman from upstate New York, currently in ninth place. He was a standout high school wrestler. Number two man is Joe Brisky, big, strong athlete who hopes to compete in L.A. USA's number three man, Tom Barnes, 24 years old from Dover, Delaware. The brake man is Hal Hoy. Now, John, yesterday Hoy had trouble getting in the sled. Are they more familiar with it now?
Well, again, they would need 10, 15, 20 trips at least to get familiar with this sled. The start times yesterday were just terrible. If Jeff Jost had any kind of positive starts, he could be in the hunt for a medal.
23rd place in the start yesterday, but he still finished ninth overall after two aggregate runs.
He's 60 hundredths behind Silvio Giobellina.
That is Hans Hildebrand's sled. They purchased it just this past Tuesday after Hans Hildebrand was dropped as an alternate to the Swiss team. They paid $10,000 for it.
The start here at Trebevich means everything. Yesterday, there are two starts. They had a 6:16 and a 6:65. Let's see if they all get in smoothly. Now let's watch. Very smooth entry into the sled.
In the sled much quicker today. 6:57, their time, still off the pace.
Well, it's still an improvement. Again, you got to give Jeff Jost a gold medal for bravery just to come down this course with this unfamiliar fast sled. He did a deep skid there.
They are using B runners. What does that mean, John?
A little bit cold weather runners. Jeff decided to switch runners up today. Again, he's unfamiliar with the sled and the runners. Watch for split times.
His time as he comes down, 33.02. He made up some time there.
Oh, he's very high in the first part of the lap. He did the dip-in, as we call it. Oh, he's late there again. He's got trouble all the way down the course.
The three late riders tucked in behind the driver. What does late mean?
Late's coming off the corner late. That doesn't give the driver the choice where he wants to come off, and that's dangerous.
Jost, 50, 89 puts him in second place currently, but the leaders are still yet to come.
Hey, fathead.
That's not a bad heat at all compared to Fassler's heat. Again, Yost comes down. He's getting more confidence with this sled every time down.
Jeff Jost, 36 years old, USA's number one driver. Silvio Giobellina, the driver of Switzerland, number one, has a very real shot at the medal. He is now trying to assault the East Germans at the top of the leaderboard. One of the smaller bobsledders, 5'8", 155 pounds, is number two man, Heinz Stettler, 6'2", 240, makes up for the weight difference. Ward Salzman sits in the third spot. Swiss national champion decathlon, Rieker Freiermuth, is the brake man, phys ed teacher, former discus and shot put champion. Now, John, as you look at the sled of Silvio Giobellina, you talked about the terrible start times that the Swiss had yesterday. Does Joby put his team at a disadvantage because of his lack of size?
No, I think that the 1982 at the World Bobsled Championships, they're only 500 or 600 off the East German starts. Here, they're 1,800 off the East German starts.
Giobellina buys the frame, then builds the sled himself, including all the intricacies of the fiberglass body. The explosion, the best start time thus far, 6:30. Bazinta Zygmantas of the Soviet Union. Giobellina's split time, 6.48.
Very similar to yesterday's start times. Again, I've never seen the Swiss four-man teams give up so much time at the start in my time watching bobsledding this past 2 decades.
Giobellina was a skier until he was 15, and he told us the other day that that helped him be aggressive on the bobsled course. He's a daredevil.
Great pilot down the course. So let's see what his split time is there compared to the Soviet. That'll be the time on the left. 270. He's 200 behind the Soviet Union there, Jimmy.
Made up some excellent time as he comes around the Omega corner. Nearly 70 miles an hour as he heads down through the labyrinth.
Oh, he almost tipped over there. He got it back up. He did the same thing in practice.
That's going to cost him time. He comes around the final curve. The time on the left, the time to beat. His time, 50:49.
Oh, I tell you, he did the same thing as first heat in practice to New. We're standing there that day. Same exact thing on two runners on the labyrinth. His team saved him there. Here's where Giobellina almost lost it. Watch him come in here, miss the take onto the corner. Look at his sled coming in. Now it's got no choice but to go up. Comes off on two runners, and this is where his team saves it. They're all pushing on the upper runner pressure. The sled flops back down. Near disaster for the Swiss.
Giobellina's aggregate time, 2:30.89, puts him in first place in the third heat, but it may not hold up. Soviet Union's number one sled. After yesterday's two heats, he was in fifth place. Jānis Kipers from the Latvian Republic, only been bobsledding since 1980. Maris Poikins, number two, 23-year-old master of sport from Latvia. Ivar Berseps is also there, a two-year veteran, 6'1", 180. The brakeman is Ivar Schneps. Strong spinner, world-class athlete. You're looking at the sled here, John, and you have to believe that he's not in full control of this sled, and I wonder if it was ready for the competition.
Boy, this is his real first international competition with this four-man shark sled, and he's had a lot of problems yesterday. This sled is a plank sled, so there's no split in the calendar or anything. Very, very different.
Jānis Kipers has had some trouble on this course controlling the sled. Now it is more chewed up than ever, and you have to believe that he's going to have trouble on this run. Best time, 6:30. His time, 6:33. Very much in the hunt.
Now, he told me up at the top of the hill this morning he has lots of problems down in 5, 6, and 7. So let's watch him in quarter 7 to see how high he is. He's got no problems here in 4 and 5. He sets himself up very nice. Now, watch him here in 5. This is where he gets a little bit of problem. Now, watch the rider's heads. If you see those rider's heads snap, that means he's had bad transitions on and off the corners. Let's watch him in 7.
Keep in mind, Kipers is sledding only since 1980. Virtually inexperienced. The same split time. He's got an excellent run going as he comes through Omega.
There he goes into he almost lost it there, too. We saw him do the same thing in practice. He's late there, too. He's got no control of the sled here.
Banging the walls as he comes through the labyrinth.
Oh!
Around the finish curve, the time on the left, the time to beat his time. 51:19 puts him in third place. He's lucky the sled is still upright.
I say he's just like Jeff Jost. He's going to get a gold medal for bravery. You're just bringing the sled down the mountain.
One thing about the shark sled, if it gets in a rut, it's going to go its own way and you lose control. Jānis Kipers, Soviet Union number one.
Let's have a look to see where he had his problems. Here we are in curve 8 in Omega. Look at him down low. Now he goes back up in the outlet. Watch the sled fly right in midair into this corner. He's airborne. Now watch the runners grabbing the sled. Watch the heads of the team, Bob. Boy, that's dangerous. Total amount of danger for the Soviet Union.